let's continue our discussions. Let's get the other side right now on the murder complaints filed against Congressman Arnulfo Teves. We're now joined by his lawyer, Attorney Ferdinand Topacio. Attorney Topacio, good morning to you, sir.
Yes, good morning, Ma'am Karen. And I'd like to thank you for this opportunity to give our side of the story.
Okay. Attorney Topacio, let's start first with this. Was Congressman Teves supposed to be on that flight? Did he think of being on that flight? Where did that come from?
To tell you frankly, I don't know where Secretary Remulla is coming from when he suddenly announced that Congressman Teves was on his way home. So I have no idea, really.
So anong palagay niyo, ano yung disinformation? Kasi may mga media na nag-abang ha, sa totoo lang.
Yun nga eh, one who occupies such a lofty position in government should exercise more circumspection in making public announcements. Hindi lang po media ang nag-abang, ang balita ko, ang dami daw police doon sa airport. You mobilize people both in the public and private sector on the basis of unverified information. Well, that is something else that you should explain to the public.
Okay. All right. Now, the NBI has already filed murder charges against Congressman Degamo. He's now a respondent in the criminal cases filed, right? So it's murder, frustrated murder, and attempted murder on several counts. So it's against Governor Degamo and nine others. So ang tanong ko, if a warrant is issued, of course, I'm moving forward now. If a warrant is issued against Congressman Teves, will he return to the Philippines willingly?
Well, first of all, about the filing of those cases, those cases are already anticlimactic because as early as March 31, Secretary Remulla has already been announcing that the case was 99.9% solved. In April 4, he had already tagged Congressman Teves as a mastermind in the Degamo killing on the basis of what? Of statements that are now being recanted by the witnesses. So this is anticlimactic. I mean, what took them so long? We have been telling them, if you have evidence, please file the same in court. I mean, before the DOJ, so we might respond to them instead of engaging in trial by publicity. Now, after more than two long months, Secretary Remulla, in effect, filed a case before himself because it is a case of the NBI, which is under him, filing a case before the DOJ, of which he is the head. So the return of Congressman Teves will depend only on one thing and one thing alone, whether or not the grave threats to his life and safety have abated.
Okay. Now, Attorney Topacio, let's start first with this. So are you saying if a warrant of arrest is issued against Teves, he will not return based on that alone?
He might not return because the Supreme Court itself has already recognized that the right of self-preservation is the primordial law. So if your intention is not to evade the processes of the court, but to secure yourself. Self-defense is a recognized right. The right to keep oneself out of danger is a recognized right, even by the Constitution and the Supreme Court.
Okay, so you've made that clear. A warrant of arrest will not make him come home. Is he in a country where there is no extradition treaty with the Philippines?
Well, you would better ask Secretary Remulla, because he seems to know more about the location of my client than I do. But extradition or not, that is really not the a prime concern of Congressman Teves. It's the safety of his family and himself.
Okay, but when you speak about safety, when I interviewed him, he did mention safety, but he also really, for him, it was an issue of fairness. So what he said was, okay lang sa kanya makulong, ayaw niyang mamatay. So ang takot niya, pag nakulong siya, mamamatay siya doon. Ayaw rin niyang makulong. So ang tanong dito is it really for him an issue that he's already been prejudged? In other words, even if his safety is guaranteed, hindi rin siya uuwi.
Well, prejudged in the sense that ahead himself of the Department of Justice has already pronounced him guilty of the murder. Ngayon, kung ikaw ang Secretary of Justice at sasabihin mong, eto na nga ang mastermind, matlakas ang ebidensya, what leeway does he leave his prosecutors in determining probable cause in a preliminary investigation where the prosecutor does not act as the person who tries to secure the conviction of the accused, but at this stage at least, he acts as an impartial quasi-judicial entity that determines whether or not there is a probable cause. So, yun po ang sinasabi ni Congressman Tevez. Paano kami makaka-assure ng fairness kung ngayon pa lang yung mismong hepe at yung boss ng mga mag-determine kung may probable cause, sinasabi ng siya ang mastermind, malakas ang ebidensya, etc. Yun po ang aming concern talaga eh. And that, now that is no longer prosecution but persecution. So, I cannot blame him if he wants to seek political asylum in another country because talagang ang nakikita po natin ang pag-uusig dito. And you know, Ma'am Karen, I wish I could reveal more at this time, but there is more to this than meets the eye. Na talagang it will lead one to conclude na talagang prejudged na yung kaso ni Congressman Tevez, at least insofar as the executive department is concerned.
Okay. Now, can you take us to the rules of court? What happens if Congressman Tevez is not present in any of the proceedings after the NBI has filed murder charges and he's not physically represented there? Yes, he has his lawyers, but what do the rules of court say considering you're charged for murder?
Well, let's not go to the rules of court first because that is statutory. Let us go to the fundamental law of the land, which is the Constitution. And the Constitution clearly states in the Bill of Rights that any person under investigation for the commission of a criminal offense has the right to be heard by himself or by counsel. That is in the Constitution. So, hindi po pwede nating masamain o bigyan ng masamang interpretasyon or take it against him or any other person if he refuses to appear either in court or in this case, the preliminary investigation represented only by counsel, sapagkat yan po mismong yung prosesong yan ay isang karapatang ginagarantiya ng ating saligang batas.
Okay, all right. Next question is how long can Congressman Tevez keep this up? If, let's say, Secretary Remulla doesn't change his tune, now that murder charges are filed against him, he's not able to speak with President Marcos Jr. because in our interview, he said he wanted to speak with President Marcos Jr. If the tide doesn't change, are you telling us that he will stay abroad for as long as it takes?
Well, only he can answer that, Ma'am Karen. But yan din po ang sinasabi namin.
Is that the life he wants to lead also?
Well, I don't know. I think that is preferable to death kasi alam niyo po yung mga napapatay. Yung napapatay, hindi po magandang experience yun eh. But at any rate, as I was going back to fairness, bakit po yung mga digamo ay kinakausap ng Secretary of Justice? Bakit po yung mga digamo ay nakikipag-party sa presidente? Why does the Secretary of Justice not give Congressman Tevez the time of day? Telepono lang naman. But sasabihin niya agad pag gusto siyang kausapin ay puro drama lang yan. Alam niyo po, Ma'am Karen, kung ito ay nasa hukuman at nakita ko na yung kabilang partido ay nakikipag-usap sa huwes kahit sa opisina niya, ipa-inhibit ko agad yun eh. Because, as I said, right now, the DOJ acts as a quasi-judicial body to determine probable cause. So, yan po ang fundamental unfairness dito. Yung mga digamo, may access sa Pangulo, may access sa Secretary of Justice. Yung abogado nila, anytime kinakausap din Secretary of Justice, bakit po kami ayaw kausapin? Kahit publicly, kahit speakerphone niya, para makita ng taong bayan kung anong pinag-uusapan, kung ayaw niyang mapagdudahan. So that in itself is another indicium of partiality and unfairness.
Oo. Because ang sabi naman ni Secretary Remulla is the behavior of Congressman Teves, flight is a sign of guilt.
Ay, hindi pa po applicable yan. Wala pa po kasing warrant eh. What is he fleeing from? And besides, we are not fleeing from anything. We are participating at lumalahok po kami sa lahat ng proseso at ng naligal kung saan po kami pinahihintulutan sapagkat ang problema naman po katulad doon sa Senate at sa House Committee on Ethics and Privileges, ayaw naman kaming pakinggan in violation of the rights of my client to due process.
Mm. All right. So what's the next move? I know that, is this correct to say, two of his sons, were charges filed against them as well? Is it illegal possession of firearms?
Yes, illegal firearms and explosives, and they are represented by another counsel, Attorney Andres Manuel Jr.
Oo. And the two sons are in the Philippines.
I believe they are not here, but of course, I have no authority to speak on their behalf.
Oo. When you say they're not here, they're also abroad.
Well, I would suppose so. I think the more competent person to speak about on this matter is Attorney Andres Manuel, their counsel.
Okay. All right. Last words, Attorney Topacio. After the NBI has filed murder charges, take us through the process of what you expect.
Well, we will respond to the charges in the best way we can. In accordance with the rules as set by the National Prosecution Service itself. And from then on, we will see what happens. But, you know, while I hope for the best, I fear for the worst that since the Secretary of Justice has already spoken about the presence of probable cause, at least on this matter, at yan nga po ang sinasabi. Kaya kumpiyansa kanina, si Mayor Janice Digamo, who has never hesitated to play the victim card. Eh, tikita nyo, pagka kami nagsasalita, mga barkers daw, pag sila, mga biktima. So, iyan ang attitude na sapagkat alam niya na kinakampihan siya ng husto ng Department of Justice. Kaya, kumpiyansa sila na magkakaroon ng probable cause. So, those are the cards that we have been dealt with. At talagang tagilid kami dahil na bias ang Secretary of Justice. But we will play the cards that we are dealt with. We have to protect the rights of our client in the best manner that we can, in accordance with our oath as lawyers.
On that note, Attorney Ferdinand Topacio, thank you so much for joining me today. And I was going to say, kung gusto lang nila malaman kung uuwi si Congressman Teves, would it be wiser na ikaw na lang ang tanungin?
Sana si Congressman Teves na lang ang tinanong nila. Kasi talagang nangyari kengkoy eh. Ha? Ang daming pulis doon, ang daming reporters eh. Pagkatapos walay.
Okay. On that note, thank you so much, Attorney Ferdinand Topacio.